Yes.
And welcome to the Pelham High School graduation ceremony to honor the Pelham High School graduating class of 2021. Woo. At this time, I'd like to invite the class Vice President Colby Walsh to the stage to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please remain standing.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Colby. Would the class marshals please seat the class? Nicely done. It is now my honor to introduce the superintendent of Pelham Schools, Dr. Eric McGee, to welcome the class.
Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. Good afternoon. My name is Chip McGee, and I have the honor of serving Pelham as the superintendent of schools. Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. That's a proverb from the country of Haiti. I share it with you today, the class of 2021, as you stand atop the mountain of Pelham High School. You have conquered it. You're at the top of this mountain. You are graduating, and we are all so proud of you. Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. From the top of this mountain, the view is great. Let's call it Mount Python. From here, you can look back and see where you came from, your glorious years here at Pelham High School, and for most of you, your time at Pelham Memorial School and Pelham Elementary School. Your teachers from the past can see you up here at the top of the mountain, and they are proud of you too. Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. So it's been a tough climb up this mountain. The challenge of classes and of schoolwork. For some of you, this meant working for another A. For others of you, it meant working as hard as you can just to pass the class. The challenge of relationships with your friends and family, they've changed as you grew from being a child into a young adult. That's to say nothing of the challenge of this pandemic. What a crazy, unforeseen senior year for the class of 2021. Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. Up here, you can see forward too, to your next mountain. You can see whatever that mountain might be. It might be entering the workforce or continuing your education at the next level. It might be starting a business or joining the military. The VFW, by the way, asked me to send congratulations to you all. And here it is, looking forward into the future, that this proverb hits home for me. After all the work it took to get to the top of this mountain, do you know what the reward is? Another mountain. The first time I heard this proverb, honestly, I found it kind of annoying. I did not want to be told that the reward for my hard work was the prospect of more hard work. But here's the deal. After climbing Mount Python, you now know you can do it. You made it through this crazy pandemic year through challenging programs with this team of teachers, your friends, and your family supporting you. You now know you are ready for the next mountain. So I congratulate you on making it to the mountaintop. And I want to honor your achievement with the best message I could think of. Beyond the mountain, there are mountains. Thank you.
Very well said, Dr. McGee. It's now my honor to introduce your principal, Ms. Dawn Mead, to address the class.
Hello, and welcome to the Pelham High School graduation ceremony celebrating the class of 2021. I would like to take a moment to welcome our honored guests, School Board Chair, Mrs. Megan Larson, Vice Chair, Mr. Troy Brissett, a warm welcome to Superintendent Dr. Eric Chip McGee, and Assistant Superintendent Dr. Sarah Mirandos. our PHS leadership team, our senior class advisors, and our amazing PHS faculty and staff, because we all know we would not be here without your hard work and commitment to our students' success. I would be remiss not to thank our PSD plant ops and custodial staff for all their hard work on setting up the venue for today. At this time, I would like to take a moment to honor members of the class of 2021 that have or will be enlisting in the military. At this time, will you please stand? For the class of 2021. Over the past 2 years, you have listened to, read, or heard 70 of my real talks. I've shared with you stories of my childhood. Some were about my family, others about my friends, but most were about the life lessons that I learned along the way. I hope that I saved the most important one for last. This is my final opportunity to talk to all of you in one place at the same time. It is my last chance to share with you my hopes and dreams for the future for all of you. I've tossed and turned for months, trying to decide what my last message should be to you, my last real talk. I wrote down ideas, I crumpled up the paper they were on. I sent myself text and deleted them. I listened to voicemails that I left myself on my cell phone. And that's right, when you get old, you call yourself and leave messages. And it finally came to me one morning, 2 weeks ago, as I headed down Marsh Road on my way to school. If I could share one last conversation with you, it would be about making choices. Because you see, everything in life, what we do, how we do it, when we do it, and why we do it, is a choice. We make them every day. Sometimes we make them every minute. We all face choices, but it is what we choose that makes all the difference. You can choose to give up. You can choose to walk away. You can choose to play it safe. You can choose to close your eyes and not see what is going on in the world around you. You can choose to hold a grudge. You can choose to protect your heart. You can choose to take the easy way out. Or you could choose to settle. I'm encouraging you to do the exact opposite. Choose to try. Choose to fall and get back up. Choose to chase your dreams. Choose to take risks. Choose to forgive. Choose to challenge yourself. Choose to love unconditionally. Choose to show grace and kindness. Choose to open your heart and mind to new experiences. Choose to love your family and friends and make sure to tell them every day. Choose to respect yourself. Choose to have fun. Choose to stand up when it is easier to sit it out. Choose to make a difference in the world. Choose to leave and not follow. But most importantly, I hope you choose to be happy. You see, at 55 years old, I've made a lot of choices. Some have been good, while others have not been the best. Because we all make mistakes, and that's okay, as long as you learn from them. Forgive yourself and promise to do better, because sometimes our failures are our best teachers. Your choices will mold and define who you are. Your choices will make all the difference. Every day when you wake up, as your feet hit the floor, say thank you out loud, because it's a new day, it's a new beginning. It's a new opportunity. It's a new chapter. It's a new adventure. It is whatever you choose it to be. I chose to be your principal. It is one of the best choices I've made. Every day, I choose to believe in all of you. I choose to believe in the grace and hope that you've shown this year. And I choose to believe that you will shine bright in the future. I hope you choose to make a lifetime full of memories. Choose to make a life that you will love and be proud of. A final reminder, it's not if, it's how they will remember you. You get to choose. Congratulations and best of luck.
Please join me in welcoming the senior class president, Ms. Lizzie Hodge, to address the class.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Hodge, and I have been representing the class of 2021 as president for the past 4 years. As a class, we are thankful to the faculty and staff of Pelham, including Ms. Mead and Mr. Barrier, for making it possible for us to celebrate and walk across the stage today. Thank you to Ms. Davitt and Ms. Pomarlo for being our class advisors and making many events happen these past years. Personally, I want to thank my parents and my two brothers for their unwavering love and support. I couldn't have done it without you guys. To the class of 2021, here we are graduating high school, and for many of us, senioritis set in somewhere around freshman year. With lots of hard work and perseverance, we did it. We made it through senior year during a pandemic. Pythons of 2021, we rocked it. We all deserve this long-awaited walk across the stage. During our time at PHS, we have had some amazing times, some frustrating times, some scary times, and some very happy times. And certainly, during this pandemic, we have faced some challenges and obstacles that have changed how we live our daily lives. But as Pelham Pythons, we did what we had to get through. We worked hard. We adjusted and rolled with the changes almost daily. If anything, getting through this pandemic made us stronger, connected us, and helped us grow as a community. We often hear the phrase, Pelham strong. Well, that couldn't be more true other than right now. We should be proud of where we are and where we are from and the place we will always call our home. Our roots are in Pelham, and we are fortunate to now be alumni of PHS. So now we are given a clean slate to become whatever and whoever we want to be. It is time for us to start adulting. Start deciding what we want to be and who we want to be when we grow up. We are being given the opportunities right now to achieve greatness. As we continue on our journey and begin to take on the world, let's strive every day to do the following. Choose kindness. Be positive. Look for the good in the world. Smile as much as possible just because you never know when it will turn a person's day around. Strive to create great relationships. Be thoughtful and kind. Leave every situation with happiness and hope. Be the kind of person you need others to be. Most of all, never give up. Remember that there is no room for hatred in this world. Do not give hatred the power to shape our lives. I promise, if we give and receive kindness, it will come back to us in abundance. So whatever you decide to do, now that you're grown up, be sure to choose kindness. It's been an honor representing the class of 2021. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very, very best for a successful future surrounded by kind and positive people. Thank you.
I now have the honor of introducing our class essayist, salutatorian, and valedictorian. This year, we have three strong and academically gifted young women accepting these honors. These three are also lucky enough to call themselves friends. In fact, they enjoyed speech day together as they gathered and wrote their speeches alongside one another. I'm honored to begin with our class essayist. During her time here at Pelham High School, Nicole Paquette has challenged herself by taking the most advanced classes possible, earning stellar grades in each. In fact, Nicole earned a spot in the Academic Hall of Fame by achieving honor roll every semester in her high school career. Her band teacher, Mr. Ryan Shumway, describes her as driven and hardworking, but says that his favorite character trait is her curiosity. These attributes have certainly served her well throughout her time here at Pelham High School. Please join me in welcoming your class essayist, Nicole Paquette, to the podium.
Usually when I'm in front of a crowd, I have an instrument in front of me. But today I find myself in the surreal position of addressing you as you move on to the next chapter of your lives. While I haven't been around the longest, I've been a part of the Pelham School District since I changed schools in the fourth grade. That may seem like a long time ago now, but I'm particularly honored to be graduating with some of my original classmates from St. Pat's. I can still picture us in the uniforms, and I wonder what we would think of us now. To say the least, we've grown up. But Whether we met in kindergarten or fourth grade, it's been a privilege to learn and grow beside you all. I know I don't only speak for myself when I think of the gratitude I have for the teachers, friends, and family that have stood by me over the years. Specifically, Mom and Dad, I couldn't have done it without you and your unconditional support and guidance. I'd also like to give a special thank you to the custodians, cafeteria workers, and other behind-the-scenes faculty that don't get nearly enough credit for the work that they do. You keep the school running, and I want you to know that it doesn't go unnoticed. Now that you've all been properly welcomed, thanked, and congratulated, I'll take this opportunity to share the wisdom gained from my many years of experience as a teenage girl. I'm just kidding, but as an 18-year-old high school graduate, I think I'm hardly in the position to offer life advice to any of you. What I can do, however, is offer the advice of someone much wiser and more historically relevant than me. For instance, the people of the internet say that Thomas Jefferson once said, "I'm a great believer in luck, and I find the harder I work, the more I have of it." I always like this quote because it takes the illusion around success away and exposes hard work and opportunity as its true components. More than that, though, it puts your luck into your own hands. As we go on to become scientists, artists, tradesmen, or in my case, a musician, I hope you all find a way to create your own luck. I hope you stumble across job opportunities, turn chance encounters into connections, and get promoted to where you want to be in life much sooner than you expect to. While everyone around you can point to luck, you'll know exactly why you are where you are. More importantly, you'll know how to get where you're going. With that, I wish you all the luck you deserve. I'd say I'll see you at the class reunion, but I'm pretty sure I'll run into you at Hannaford's or Brando's first. Happy graduation day, nerds.
Reka Ivanyi can easily be described as a model student. She is an exceptionally talented young woman, noted for her artwork, but her talents extend far beyond the art wing here at Pelham High. Reka's biology teacher, Dr. Janet Holden, describes her as a Renaissance individual excelling in a wide range of arts and academics. Reka has challenged herself taking the most advanced classes, and she has achieved success in all of them. In fact, Reka earned high honors in every semester of her high school career. Despite these many accomplishments, Reka remains humble and level-headed. Please join me in welcoming your class salutatorian, Reka Ivanyi, to the podium.
Thank you, everyone, for being here. There's no words to explain how thankful I am for my teachers, my friends, and my family. To my family, as they say in Hungarian, Köszönöm szépen. Thank you to the weather for holding it together today, and thank you for Emily for letting me into your house to write this, and to Nicole as well for lending me your speechwriting wisdom while I tried to remember how to put words together in a way that makes sense. Some of you, probably most of you, are ready to run across the stage, take a few pictures, go home, and never return. You've been waiting for this moment for as long as you can remember and counting down the days. I don't doubt that there were some unenjoyable moments in your high school experience, but I hope that just for one moment you can reflect on these past 4 years and think of at least one life-affirming memory. Something that makes you think, huh, guess that was nice. Like maybe a time you spent a whole weekend filming a sophomore English project, or a time you sat in the art room laughing about shrimp for the 3,000th time. Or maybe the time we miscalculated the wind speeds and the homecoming bonfire almost went very badly. It's these little memories that make it worth it, and it's these things that you'll remember years from now. Keep your memories close as you move on to what's next. I don't think you can have a grad speech without a deep, unnecessary metaphor, so here it goes. Right now is an interesting time. It's like you're standing on the edge of a cliff, about to jump into the chasm that is your future. It seems like everything is finally coming together. Everything you've worked for during the past 12 years is coming to a close. You're about to graduate or to move on to the next chapter. However, it isn't a new chapter, it's a whole new book. So, embrace whatever is to come and make as many memories as possible. You're standing on a cliff of possibility. There's beautiful things in the future. There will be people that you're going to come to love and people you'll never forget. This book will be filled with pages and pages of memories, chapter upon chapter of laughing, learning, and experiencing things you never thought possible. It would be nice to have some meaningful, famous quote to share with you all, but instead I have a sentence that has stuck out to me from some obscure YouTube video I saw a few weeks ago. Whatever your plans are for the future, and however much they completely change, keep this in mind. If you're happy, no one has the right to tell you that you're not successful. So, in conclusion, it's the little things that count. The future is exciting, and shrimp are funny. Thank you.
The honor of valedictorian is bestowed upon the student with the highest GPA in the graduating class. This year's valedictorian is Emily Michaud. Though academically gifted and well known for embracing hard work, her teachers seemed particularly impressed by her non-academic characteristics. Emily's college composition teacher, Dr. Linda Fox, noted that personal fulfillment and character development are important parts of her life and that her memories of good times bring her comfort and laughter. I know that I can personally attest that I never see Emily without a smile on her face. Having taken a rigorous course load at Pelham High School and earning honors every semester during her academic career, we here at Pelham High are proud of all that Emily has accomplished. Please join me in welcoming your class valedictorian, Emily Michaud, to the podium.
Thank you, Mr. Barrier, and thank you to the students, parents, teachers, and other staff that are here right now. When I realized that I was going to have to write a graduation speech, I was super nervous. The only thing I knew was that my speech would be written in 12-point Times New Roman font, and it would most definitely be double-spaced. For the past 12 years, we've watched each other grow up. Pelham is unique in that way. We have one elementary school, one middle school, and one high school. This means that for most of our lives, we have gone to school with the same people. To this day, I still talk to people from my first grade class, sharing our favorite memories. For the sake of everyone else, I'm not going to share these memories because they're really not an all-around relatable experience. Instead, I want to remind you all of our shared history. No matter how far we've strayed from each other throughout our years, we can still follow our childhood back to the same place. Together, we've been panthers, tigers, and pythons. Apparently, Pelham is a fan of carnivores, which I think is pretty fitting. We're an intimidating bunch. Each and every one of us is about to have new experiences outside of Pelham. No matter what, we have to remember that we are predators, not prey. We get to decide what happens in our lives from this point forward. I know the parents in the audience aren't really a fan of the idea that we're all about to leave, but I think it's time. 12 years is an awfully long time to be stuck in one place. Many of us would not be here today without our parents, peers, teachers, and other staff. I would like to say a special thanks to my mom, Mrs. Michaud. Thank you for being my mother and a wonderful school-to-career coordinator. I am so proud to be your daughter. I think my fellow graduates can agree with me when I say that you were one of the many people that kept us grounded this year. Without you, I quite literally wouldn't be here. Thank you to Nicole and Reka for listening to my speech 1,000 times. I would say speech writing day was a great success, like Mr. Barrier said. There was a point in time where we all looked at the 21 at the end of our login usernames, thinking that the year 2021 is so far away. Well, we made it. I'll admit that saying goodbye is scary, but we must remember that, as cheesy as it sounds, we are saying hello to our future. I wish you all the best of luck on your future endeavors. Be proud of how far you've come.
I would now like to invite Principal Mead back to the podium.
We will now begin the moment you have all been waiting for, the conferring of diplomas. Mrs. Larson, as chair of the Pelham School Board, I present to you the graduating class of 2021 and certify as principal of Pelham High School that these students have successfully met the graduation requirements as set forth by the Pelham School Board. Graduates, as your name is called, please pick up the diploma and pause briefly for a photo. As a reminder to the audience, please be respectful of names as they are read so that each graduate can enjoy their moment. Assisting in the handing out of diplomas will be Superintendent Dr. Chip McGee and School Board Chair Mrs. Megan Larson. Assisting by reading names will be our Assistant Principal, Mr. Adam Barrier. At this time, I would like to ask the marshals to prepare the graduates to receive their diplomas.
Elizabeth Lee Hodge. Colby Patrick Walsh. Casey Marie Chamberlain. Andrew Thomas Strout. Reka Emma Ivani. Megan Eva Frechette. Sydney Elizabeth Nutter. Joseph Timothy Hooley. Emily Lynn Michaud. Nicole Anna Paquette. Shiza Afzal. Madison Olivia Allard. Braden Matthew Allen. Tristan Alexander Archer. Miguel Angel Baez. Elise Kelly Baisley. DJ Bassnett. Sierra Bassett. Emily Grace Bales. Max Robert Bedard. Ryan John Bellarossi. Emily Ann Berard. Valdinio Bernecht. Bryce Matthew Bienvenu. Kaylee Madeline Blanchett. Nicholas Robert Brancheri. Emily Celia Brusso. Alexander Raymond Brunel. Braylon Michelle Buckley. Andrew Jonathan Butler. Talon Ann Carney. Sarah Quinn Catazzoni. Jacqueline Claire Cothron. Alan Thara Vikia Che. Tatum Elizabeth Cheney. Anthony Cherko. Olivia Marie Coakley. Sean Michael Connors. Brianna Marie Coombs. Justin Joseph Corbett. Caleb Michael Croto. Madison Rose Curran. Stephen Mark DeMore. Maria Noor Dager. Gwyneth Olivia Dallinger. Rebecca Rose Dotel. Christopher Scott Davis. Zachary Thomas Davis. John Anthony DeBrum. Dylan James DeFranzo. Olivia Marie DiLoretto. Jolie DeSimone. Nicole Rose DeSimone. Jenny Rose Damaris. Madison Noel DiDomenico. Jonathan Paul Doherty. Stephen George Duchesne. Jake Robert Dumont. Olivia Edgerly. Mason James Fecto. James Michael Furchak. Lillian Grace Flanders. Michael James Flanders.
Yeah, let's go!
Christina Jean Fox. Isabel Marie Foy. Dahlia Jules Furtado. John Joseph Galliatalanza. Jordan Hope Galgay. Amanda Rose Gamash. Michael Edward Gendro. Sarah Lynn Jinowitz. Jackson Abbott Gottschall. Joseph Zachary Haley. Clayton Robert Hansford. Brianna Elizabeth Harper. Kylie Francis Harrington. Jacqueline Janet Harvey. Casey Marie Haverty. Jake Anthony Hurling. Layla Sky Higginbottom. Christian Michael Hobbs. Paige Ryan Hurst. Cameron Nicholas Hyder. Elise Connolly Jedrazak. Sophia Michelle Jensen. Matthew Christopher Jones. Zachary Stephen Jones. Zachary Russell Jordan. Laura Joan Kelly. Gino Jacob Cusa. Jeremy Michael Quelan. James Andrew Langenfeld. Kyle Jacob LaPlante. Joelle Jean LeBlanc. Byung Hun Lee. Jordana Diamond LaRich. Joshua Raymond Latender. Dylan Norman Levesque. Meadow Elizabeth Lindsay. Noah Paul Lloyd. Nathan Christian Long. Ada Lee. Matthew Joseph McGator. Isabella Holly Marcus. Gabrielle Marie Martin. Connor James Maslanic. Casey Lee McKeon. Cecilia Rose Michaud. Megan Alexandra Molitari. Xavier Antonio Mondejar. Nathan Timothy Monette. Gregory Donald Nichols. Ryan Sebastian Nicolosi. Dylan James Nutter. Kaylin Aline Orlando. Sky Marie Ortega. Yeah! Anthony Angel Ortiz. Sophia Rose Willette. Candace Marie Pacheco. Logan Vincent Palumbo. Joseph Anthony Padalano. Kenneth Joseph Polowitz. Alexander Michael Petty. Megan Ann Pendergast. John Roger Perrin. Colleen, Brianne Peters. Cole Daniel Phillips. Justin Daniel Pike. Allison Taylor Putnam. Zoe Jean Ratcliffe. Madison Grace Rabito. Connor Joseph Rowling. Drew Steven Saka. Cameron Thomas Santolicito. Robert Joseph Sauer. Jonathan Christopher Savage. Abby Isabel Schwab. Cameron Valentine Shaver. McKenna Renee Sheehan. Patrick James Soontorn Papuit. Nathan Bryant Sprague. Catherine Ellen St. Hilaire. Emma Madison Strangman. Joshua Gerald Serpernot. Charles Bradford Zatella. Jillian Elizabeth Tobin. Cassidy Sora Tomio. Ethan Ian Vauder. Kelsey Rose Vinciguerra. Dylan Elizabeth Walsh. Emily Perez Walther. Kevin Edward Williams. Stuart Spence Withrow. Mia Elizabeth Wozniak. Charles David Wright. Yes, Antonio Michael Zolt.
At this time, I would ask the entire graduating class of 2021 to please stand. My final request as your principal is for you to please move your tassels from right to left. Congratulations, graduates. Marshals, please prepare the class to exit.
Told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave, I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe, the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe, the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones that it ain't. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Go.